Hello researchers, how are you? I hope you are fine and doing well. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to install PrestaShop on CentOS 7. Before we proceed with the installation of PrestaShop on CentOS 7, let us first of all get ourselves aware regarding what is meant by PrestaShop. PrestaShop is a free open source e-commerce solution. The software is published under open software license. It is written in PHP programming language with support for the MySQL database management system. PrestaShop is currently used by 250,000 shops worldwide and is available in 60 different languages. So which means that if you are an e-commerce enthusiast and you want to sell something online and you want to make some e-commerce website, this PrestaShop software will be the best content management system to enable you to develop your e-commerce website. So if you talk of the history, PrestaShop started in 2005 as a student project within the EP Tech IT school in Paris, France. Originally named PHP Open Store, the software was first available in two languages, English and French. 3 months after its launch, the project was translated into 13 languages. The company PrestaShop SA was founded in 2007 by Igor and Bruno. Between May 2010 and April 2012, PrestaShop grew from 17 employees to more than 100 with the establishment of secondary headquarters in Miami. In March 2014, PrestaShop SA secured $9.3 million in Series B funding to continue its global expansion efforts. In January 2015, the company launched PrestaShop Cloud, a free self-hosted version of its software, so which means that company entered into cloud computing technology also. And according to technology tracking website BuiltWith.com, the market share of PrestaShop for open source e-commerce websites is 9%, and according to W3 Techs, PrestaShop is used by 0.5% of all websites. So if we talk of the business model as an open source organization, PrestaShop is faced with the challenge of generating revenues. By leveraging the size and international scope of its open source community, the company established two main sources of revenue. The first point, PrestaShop add-ons, a marketplace through which the merchants purchase custom add-ons and themes for their stores. Strategic partnerships, which is number two, with e-commerce industry leaders such as PayPal or Google. So if you can open the website that is called prestashop.com/en, you can find create your own free online store. Your e-commerce success starts here. You can click on this send online and you can see the live demo, and you can download the PrestaShop and PrestaShop Expert. Showcase is there and you can find very good templates which I will be demonstrating how to install on CentOS 7. And community is ever growing as it is written in PHP. It's an open source, which means that you can even contribute your code into this, and you can even start your PrestaShop store. And you can find all the live demos. So if I click on these features, you can find you are in creative control, very creative control, stand out with mobile responsive design, which means that if you design a website for the any web browser to be opened on laptop or tablet, it can be very responsive towards your tablets as well as your mobile phones. So more than 2000 plus professional e-commerce website templates, meet our network of expert designers, mark your way. So you can say a very beautiful features which you can have. And if you click on learn, let's see what they will happening for us. And you can find that it can give you some online benefits, or you can say online platforms to install or make your own website. And you can click on training, you can go to community, you can take their blog, you can create your own store. So PrestaShop is a vibrant community for making the e-commerce website. So let us start with the part B of my video, in which I will be demonstrating how to install PrestaShop on CentOS 7. So let us first of all start our virtual machine, in which I have already installed CentOS and created the Yum EPL release repository. So let me log in with root. So you can see that I have already demonstrated you with the installation of EPL repository in almost all of my videos. So you can type the first command as I've done with this command. So I will not repeat the same command into this video. So let us first of all start with step two, that is disabling of SE Linux firewall. So let us give this command set enforce 0, so which we disable our SE Linux firewall. So now we have to install the Apache web server. Let us go with the part A of this video. Let us start with the installation of Apache web server. So let us go with this command yum space minus y, which is an argument, which means I don't have to press y again. With minus y, install httpd. So with this command, it will be downloading and installing Apache web server, and then we will be starting it. So it's a very good PrestaShop. You can find a very good platform. So download size is about 3 MB. So it is downloading and it will be taking 10 MB of my hard disk space. So now let us start the Apache web server with the command. Let me clear this. systemctl start httpd. So the daemon has been started. So let me enable this so that we can be able to boot the Apache httpd server. We don't have to again go with the command enable, etc. It will be started as soon as you reinstart or reboot your system. So with the command systemctl enable httpd. So website has been started. So let us test this with systemctl status httpd. So you can see that it is active and it is running. So let me confirm this by clicking on applications and going to the web browser. And let me type on the address bar that is called localhost. You can even type with the IP address of this machine. Like if I do over here, ifconfig, that is called 192.168.1.102. So let me type this command also. 192.168.1.102. So again, you can see that it has testing 123, and with this page, we can assure that Apache web server has been successfully installed. So let us proceed with the next part, that is we have to enable the mod rewrite module into our Apache web server. So let us open this file with the command vi space slash etc slash httpd slash conf slash httpd.conf. So come downstairs and you can find over here under directory override none. We have to change this. Let us go to insert mode and let us go to the change of this, that is override none from override all. So let me confirm this. Yes, so let me save this, and now the part B is to start with the installation of MariaDB database server. With this command yum install MariaDB hyphen server space MariaDB. So it is about 22 MB of size. So let us press Y and let us press enter. So till it downloads and till it installs, let me pause the video. So now you can see that it has been installed. So let us go with the full screen mode and let us clear this. So now what we have to start the MariaDB server, that is systemctl start MariaDB. So it has been started, and now we have to configure the server, that is with the command mysql underscore secure underscore installation. So if you don't have to set the current password of root, so let us press enter and let us set the current password. So press Y and press enter and type the new password. So remove anonymous user, press Y. Disable remote login, press Y. Again press Y for testing database removal, and reload a privilege table, press Y. So we are done with the database configuration, and now we have to go with the installation of PHP. Now why we have to install PHP? Because in the explanation I have already told you that that the PrestaShop is being written in PHP. So it is very important for you to install PHP into your system. So let us go with the installation of PHP along with its PHP dependency. So let us copy this and let us paste it. So it will take about 9 MB to download, so it will not take much time. So as you can see, it is very fast. Yes, we are done, and it is updating the system towards PHP. Now we have to install the PHP myadmin so that we can be able to create the tables and do some admin tasks along with PrestaShop. Let's install it. So again, some dependencies, and the download size is about 7.2 MB. So again, not taking much time, we will be completing the installation. So now what after that is to restart the Apache web server. So it is installing PHP myadmin now and downloading also. Yes, so now you can see that the download has finished and it will not take much time for installation. Good. So now let us restart the service, that is with the command that is systemctl restart httpd.service. So let us go again to the browser and let us open this web page, that is localhost/phpmyadmin. So now you can see that the myhpin web page has been there, so which means that I have successfully configured my web server, my PHP, as well as phpmyadmin. So now let us start with the last part of this video, that is with installation of PrestaShop. So let us first of all make some directory for PrestaShop, mkdir PrestaShop. So let us go to this cd PrestaShop. So let us open the web browser and let us download the PrestaShop from this icon with this link. Copy and let us paste it. PrestaShop.com/en/download, which I've already told you. And I will be taking this website for downloading that PrestaShop. So it is about 21 MB of software, so click on download now. And you can see that the download of PrestaShop will start in few seconds. So you can see 20.5 MB of size, so let us click on save file and let us press OK. So it will be downloaded into your downloads folder. So let us go to this folder, that is CD downloads, and let's wait for PrestaShop to complete the download. So we have to copy that PrestaShop file to /root/PrestaShop folder. So what, 5 MB more? So depending on your internet speed, it will take less time, but it is right now taking some more time in my PC. So the latest version we are taking, that is 1.6.1.5. So good. So it has been downloaded. So let us close this tab and let us come to this. Yes. So let us come to this, that is called PrestaShop_1.6.1.5 has been downloaded. So let us copy this, that is copy PrestaShop to /root/PrestaShop folder. So let us go to this CD folder, that is CD PrestaShop, and you can see that the PrestaShop has been copied. So let us fire this command, that is unzip PrestaShop. So let us go with the ls. So we have the folder, that is that PrestaShop folder in which everything has been unzipped. So let us copy this folder to /var/www/html. So let us copy this command and let us paste it. It has copied. Yes. So let us change the permission of this PrestaShop folder. Good. So let us change the owner, Apache, so that we can install it on our computer. Good. So let us now test into browser that whether we are able to open PrestaShop or not. So go to this command, that is localhost/PrestaShop. So let's wait for the localhost. Yes. Yes, so now you can see that it has come and it is saying that welcome to PrestaShop 1.6.1.5 installer. So which means that everything has been configured successfully into my machine. So click on the you have to select the language, so it is English, so I will not make any change. So click on next. So there are the steps. So we have to go with the license agreement now. So I agree to the license agreement and click on next. Yes, so now you can see that there is some error which has come. We are currently checking PrestaShop compatibility with your system environment and there are some permissions problem. So this is the problem which I have seen in almost every person's computer, and lots of people have even asked this question regarding PrestaShop on Ubuntu forums, askubuntu.com, or even on CentOS forums. So let me tell you how to correct this problem. So what you have to do is to go to this folder, that is cd/where/www/html. So now what you have to do, as you know that I have in the previous command, I have given the permission that is 775, which is for the user group and the outside world, and for the outside world it is 5. So I just changed the permission to 777. Maybe it is, you can say, unsecure, but maybe in the future versions we cannot find any bug like this. So let us copy and let us click it. And now let us refresh the browser and see whether the error is gone or not. So let us wait for the localhost. Now you can see that we are currently checking PrestaShop compatibility with your system environment. And you can see that PrestaShop compatibility with your system has been verified. So which means some permissions problem may be there, but you have to see that whether it how to resolve it. So click on next. So now what you have to do is to give the other details. So let us go with the shop name, that is maybe my name as this. So let me choose the activity as computer hardware and software. Let me choose the country as India. Okay, so let us go with my first name. Let me take my name as its last name and my email address, which is anandnayar@gmail.com. So let me give the shop password and let us press next. So the shop has almost been configured. So password is there. So let me increase the characters of the password and make it somewhat strong. So I'm giving all the details like a step-by-step demonstration. So now let us pass. So now before you go proceed, you can see that the database name is PrestaShop over here. So what you have to do is to log in with the root over here and you have to create a database of PrestaShop. So click on new and take the database as PrestaShop and click on create. So database has been created. Now give the root password which you have created under MySQL underscore secure underscore installation. Let me give this password and let us click on next. So don't press next unless or until you don't have created the database. So you can see that you must create a database. So now you can see that every setting has been done successfully. It is creating database tables, default shop and languages, and very soon we will be welcoming with our the main template which I have chosen. So you can see over here also till it installs that about 2000 plus ready to use templates and 3000 plus powerful modules. So let us wait for some time. It will take about less than a minute to install PrestaShop. So creating default shops and languages and populate the database tables and configuring the shop information. We are almost done. Installing demonstration data. Installing the modules. And installing add-on modules. So everything goes step by step. So wait. So installing the theme and we are done. So you can see that the installation is finished and it has seen my name, my email and display. And let us go and start using our store. So manage your store, click on this and let us come to discover your store. So at the first time it will take some time, but after that you can see, voila, that my store has been created. And you can find very good templates, professional website, and you can go to more things also in this and that. So you can click over here and you can find that some administration might be there. So you can click on this for admin and you can go with the administration part also. So in this video I have demonstrated how to install PrestaShop step by step on CentOS 7. It's a very good platform to create your e-commerce website. If you want to start your own website for selling some products or any theme type product, you can use this PrestaShop only. I recommend for making your dynamic PHP based website. So do give this a like, do share with friends. Thanks for watching. Thank you.